Our customer service department frequently gets asked, what can I eat while I'm fasting? Now, you wonder, did they Google anything? The answer is no. Or maybe they didn't, they didn't understand it, which I can kind of sympathize with because there's a lot of weird articles out there that are kind of nonsensical. So we're gonna straighten everything out right here. Now, fasting means you're not consuming anything. Now, there's also evidence that you can get away with over the course of, let's say, an entire day, get away with putting 50 calories in your body and you won't break the fast. So it's like, it's not like you're intending to go on a 6-day fasted period, and if you accidentally swallow a bug, you have to say, well, that's ruined. No, it's not. There's a very minimum amount of calories that you can take in. It's 50. Part of the reason why a dose of Fortigen is 4 usable calories. We have that situation where we can get away with a little bit of certain things without breaking the fast, but primarily you're drinking like black coffee, or maybe black coffee with a little bit of medium chain triglyceride to just keep the fasted period as efficient as possible and not introducing anything that's gonna stop the fasted benefits. And keep in mind, a lot of the fasted benefits come on after 24 hours or even after 48 hours. Autophagy, it takes a long time for this to start, and there's been different hour numbers assigned to autophagy, but this is cellular recycling, old cells being metabolized to create new cells. But you have to be void of food for a long period of time for this. You have to keep that in mind. So you're not looking for breaks. You're not looking for ways to screw it up. Now, here's a big question. Why is fasting better than caloric restriction? Now, the truth is you can do both at the same time. So it's not really like some religious war like you would maybe see on the internet where somebody's advocating for one way versus the other way. You can have both of these things. Now, the difference is made crystal clear in an animal-based study done with mice. They have a very fast metabolism, so it's very easy to see what's going on in a mouse. Also, mice are not filling out a survey like humans do. So sometimes somebody answers a question in the way they would like to view themselves, not in reality. But a mouse in a cage is not going to go out drinking at night, or maybe have a pizza and then forget he had the pizza. In the study that I'm discussing, there are two groups of mice, a control group and a test group. The control group was allowed access to food all day long of a specific calorie amount. The other group was given that same amount of calories in a given period of time. They all consumed the exact same amount of calories. So one group of mice was one meal a day. The other group could eat throughout the day. There was a dramatic difference in fat loss and in insulin sensitivity in the test group. So the fasted group did much better. So when somebody says caloric restriction is the same thing as fasting, they could not be more wrong. Keep that in mind and remember this, because I want you to link back to this video. So if somebody wants to argue, they can argue with me. You also want to experiment with longer fasted periods. The longer the period of the fast, the more benefits you're gonna get, and they get amplified over time. I think 3 days is really fantastic. I enjoy a 3-day fasted period, so that's 72 hours. There's even apps that'll time your fasted period. I don't know if those are great because you keep looking at the app thinking about when you're gonna eat. No, you don't wanna focus on when you're gonna eat. You wanna focus on how good you feel by not eating anything, because you get that amplification of brain activity. Basically, your blood is not flowing to the intestines. It's available for everything else, for optimal training, brain function. I know that when I was doing work on the book Weightlifting is a Waste of Time, my most productive days were the fasted days. That's something to keep in mind. But I hope all this helps, and feel free to ask more questions about time-restricted eating periods.